Hi guys, it's been a while. Welcome to today's tutorial. In today's lesson, we're going to learn about calculating distance to the nearest feature in QGIS. You can subscribe to this channel to follow all my previous useful GIS tips and tutorials. For those who want to take up a complete course from basic to advanced GIS in various sectors, you can join us at Wise GIS by following this link. I will provide all useful links in the description below. Let's get started. So in today's lesson, we're going to be learning about calculating distance to the nearest feature in QGIS. And this might be the nearest distance from a river, the nearest distance from a road. For example, maybe an ATM from a road. You can also calculate the distance from the nearest internet cable line or maybe the nearest electricity line. And this works with two sets of vector layers. So let's go to QGIS and look at today's exercise. I'm going to open QGIS. And I'm going to load my vector layers that I want to use in this exercise. I'm going to go to layer, add vector layer. Now I'm going to browse for where my vector layers are, and I have two vector layers of Kenya data that I want to use in this exercise, so I'm going to load all of them. So I have the Kenyan water data, which is a boundary layer, and I have the Kenyan roads. So I'm going to click on open, then add. Then I'm going to let my layers load into QGIS, and then I'm going to click on close. And I have my two vector layers here. You can see the first layer that I have is the Kenyan roads. And I also have the Kenyan word data. I'm going to actually select my area of interest. And my area of interest, I'm just going to zoom into any area and just select any polygon. So I have identified where I want actually to select my data from. So I'm going to select the Kenyan word data. And then I'm going to use the select feature tool to select my area of interest. So I have selected these as my area of interest, and then I want to create a new layer out of it. I'm going to right click on the layer, then go to export, and then save only the selected feature. And I'm going to browse how I'm going to save my selected feature, and I'm going to call it area of interest. Area of interest. I'm going to click on save. Then I'm going to click on OK. And now I have my area of interest. I can actually do away with the Kenya data. I'm going to remove it. So I'm remaining with now my area of interest, and I also want to also get the road networks just within this area of interest. So I'm going to do a clipping. I'm going to go to vector, then I'm going to go to the geoprocessing tool. Then I'm going to select clip, and I'm going to clip this layer using my area of interest. So I'm going to select the road as my input layer and the area of interest as my clip layer. Then I'm going to click on run, and it pretty much does the clipping very quickly in 65 seconds. I'm going to click on close. And now I have a temporary layer here called clip. So I'm going to remove this. I'm going to remove these other rods. But I remain with my clip layer. Now I have my area of interest. I'm going to zoom to layer. And I also have my rod networks. So the next thing we need to have is we need to have some point data. What I'm going to do to have some point data, just for an example for this case, I'm going to create some random points in this area. But before I do that, I need to actually change the coordinate reference system, that is the projection of my data, from geographic coordinate system to a projected coordinate system. So to do that, I'm going to go to vector. I will start with my area of interest. So I'm going to go to vector. Data management tools, then I'm going to reproject my layer so that I have my projected coordinate system. And you can see currently our coordinate system is geographic. So the input layer has these, and I'm going to change the target layer. So I'm going to select this, and I'm going to select 37 South because this is within the southern hemisphere of Kenya, which is my country. So this my area of interest is actually somewhere here. So, and it falls within this range. So you can read the description about this here. So I'm going to select my UTM zone, which is 37 South, and I'm going to click on OK. And now I want to project it from geographic to my UTM values. And you can see here, it tells you the area of use is between 36 degrees east and 42 degrees east, which my area of interest falls in. So I'm going to click on run to reproject my layer. That is my area of interest. And it has done the reprojection. So I'm going to click on close. and I'm going to, it's actually a temporary scratch layer. I'm going to remove my area of interest, my initial area of interest. So I'm going to do the same thing for my clip layer, which is my road networks. I'm going to reproject it. So I'm going to go to vector layer, say do the same thing, vector, data management tools, reproject layer. I'm going to select the roads clipped, and my initial CRS, which is the coordinate reference system, is 4326, which is geographic. I'm going to change it to UTM again. So I'm going to select 37 south, still in the same region, in the southern hemisphere. Then I'm going to click on run. And I have already done the reprojection. So I'm going to click on close. Now, I'm going to remove the clip layer again, so that I have my two reprojected layers for use. And I'm also going to change my project's coordinate reference system. So I'm going to click on this down here. Then I'm going to change it to 37 south, which is still the same area. I'm going to click on apply, okay. And my project now is in the UTM 37 south. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to rename this two layers. One is my area of interest, so I'm going to rename it to my area of interest again. So we're going to rename also the road layers. I'm going to rename to roads. And all these, remember, are temporary layers. Now, the next thing we want to do is we want to now create random points within this area of interest. To do that, you're going to go to vector. Then I'm going to go to the research tools. And under the research tools, you have several things you can actually do. So I want to create some random points in a polygon, which is my area of interest. And you can see my area of interest has already been selected. But if you don't have it selected, you can just drag and drop it there. Then the number of points that I want is maybe, say, let me say I want 170 points. And the minimum distance between the points, which is optional, I want to say I want it to have a minimum distance of maybe say 400 meters, because you can see my computation is in meters. So I want it, the smallest distance between the points to be not less than 400 meters. Then I'm going to just leave everything else the way it is, and I'm going to click on run. And when I click on close, you can actually see now I have some random points within my area of interest. So I'm going to, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to right click on my layer, open the attribute table, and you can actually see it has actually just picked almost everything that is related to this layer. So I'm going to do some customization. I'm going to delete these unnecessary fields because it's just repetition. I'm going to click on the yellow pencil on my attribute table. Then I'm going to click on delete fields. Then I'm going to delete everything apart from the random points ID. So I'm going to delete all these apart from my random points ID. Okay. And then I'm going to click on the save button and then stop editing. So I have my random points from point zero. I can actually change this to point, let me just check the last point. Yes, 160, 170. So I can change it, instead of zero, I can put it to 170. So I'm going to click on edit and write 170. So click on save, stop editing. So I have my 170 points from point 1 to point 170. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to rename this layer. I'm just going to do an assumption. I'm going to just call these ATMs. So I'm going to rename. And I'm going to assume these are actually ATMs. This is just an assumption. It's not the real data. I'm going to assume these are ATMs that are within this area. So I want to just see which ATM actually is close to which road and what is the distance between the ATM and the road. So to do that, I'm going to need another plugin. There are actually two ways you can actually do it. The first way is by using a plugin, and then there's another way I'm going to show you later on. So we're going to start with the plugin. So I'm going to go to plugins, manage and install plugins. And then under the plugin tab, I'm going to select all. And then in the search area here, I'm going to type NN join. And then I'm going to select the NN join plugin. The NN join plugin is the nearest neighbor join and it actually joins the vector layers based on their nearest neighbor relationships. So this is actually a very useful plugin, and it has so many downloads, so it means it's very useful in the QGIS community. So I'm going to install the plugin. I've already installed the plugin, so if you haven't installed it, you click on install. I can click on reinstall the plugin to just make sure that everything is fine and maybe all the updates are available. So my plugin has been reinstalled successfully. I'm going to click on close. Now we have the roads data and we have the ATMs. So what we want to do is we want to bring this data into our NN join plugin. So to access it, you can go to vector, and under vector you'll find the NN join plugin. So I'm going to select NN join plugin. So our input layer is the ATMs. You can see it has selected the ATMs, and then the join vector layer is going to be our roads, because we want to approximate the distance between from the ATMs to the road, the shortest distance from the ATM to the road. So you can actually add a prefix here, but I'm just going to leave it. So everything else that is going to be added in our attribute table will have an underscore join. The output layer is going to be ATM roads. I'm going to just say ATM roads with distance. Then I'm going to click on OK. And it starts running the whole process and takes quite a very short time. And you can actually see when I click on close, I have some new point data here called the ATM road. This is the one that we have just created. I'm going to right click on the data and let's open the attribute table to see what it has. And you can actually now see that it has actually joined some of the other information into our random points. So you can actually see the very important attribute that we are actually looking for is the distance, and you can see this distance is in meters. So you can actually change these to maybe kilometers if you want, or maybe reduce the decibels, you know, depending on how you want to use this data. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to label my points and the distance on my map. So I'm going to right click on the layer, then go to properties, then labels, because I want to label these using the ID and also the distance. So I'm going to say single labels, and then I'm going to use the value that I'm going to be using. I'm going to actually create an expression. So I'm going to say, let me create an expression, and then I'm going to delete everything here. So I'm going to put an expression for my labels, and I'm going to say I want to label. I'm going to go to field and values. I want to label using the random point ID, and then I'm going to, in a new line in the same, I'm going to concatenate, then create a new line, then concatenate again, and now I'm going to use the distance. So I'm going to have, there's a preview here of the point and the point ID and the distance between that and the road. So I'm going to click on OK. Then I'm going to click on create a buffer for that, apply OK. So they are actually very visible, and you can actually see this is our result. So let's just zoom into an area. Like for example, this point here, 0.97, which is saying that it's around actually 107 meters, 107.9 meters from the road. So I'm going to just nearest road. So I'm going to just zoom in up to that. Then I'm going to try to measure. So I'm going to be using the measure tool up here. I'm going to select the measure line. Then I'm going to just select my point here. And I'm going to look at the, is it roughly 100 and around 107, the nearest? You can see there's 110 here. So it's around maybe somewhere, maybe around here if I'm accurate. So you can actually see that's the distance. Then I can go to the other point. Maybe say this 0.120, which is 83 meters from the road. Let me just check and see if that is the truth of the matter. I'm going to select the point. Then I'm going to select to the nearest road, and you can actually see it's roughly around 832 meters. So we can actually do that for as many points as we can, and you can actually see this is actually a very easy way of getting these distances very, very quickly. So from our attribute table, if we look at the shortest distance, which point has the shortest distance, which ATM is nearest to the road. We can actually click on the distance here to sort our data in ascending order. You can see the shortest is 0.125, which is 12.4 meters. So I can actually select this, then zoom to the selection, then I can just look at it on the map, and you can see actually this is the point, the ATM that is actually nearest to the road. So I can select this, and then you can see it's around 12 meters. So the other way of actually doing this is by using the processing toolbox. If you don't have the processing toolbox here, you can actually go to processing and select the process, the toolbox. So what you're going to do is I'm going to just search for join attributes to. So we're going to select join attributes to the nearest. Then now we're going to input our layers, and remember our two layers were the ATM and the rod. First, so I'm going to click on run, and you can see it pretty much does very, very fast. So I'm going to click on close. So I'm going to open the attribute table to see if we have the same result, and you can actually now see it has all similar results to that, because you can see the 0.170 is a 2.44 distance in meters. And if I click on on the distance here, you can actually see the shortest distance is 12 meters, and this is very helpful because it gives you the XY of the nearest features, and you can see all these are in UTM values. So you can actually be able to now get the real link up between this point and the road by looking at these X and Y coordinates. So that's it for today's exercise. If you want to learn more on GIS in various sectors, you can join us at WISE GIS. You can access our website from any browser. Select the course you want to learn by going to the training tab. Then the course that you want to learn, like so, say for example, advanced GIS and mapping. Then read the description about the course. Click the register tab, which will redirect you to the contact form. Fill out and wait for your admission. If you found this video useful and you want to learn more on GIS, subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Otherwise, I'm happy you're here. See you in my next video.